Welcome back. Now, every day in this country, some part or the other, we see images of violence. But this is a new low because this appears to be the Assam police itself. Its brutality being caught on camera. An anti-encroachment drive that turned into deadly clashes. The police opening fire on unarmed locals, brutally thrashing them with sticks in Darang district, including the photographer, the official photographer who had come there of the government, also was involved in the beating up. Two people killed, 9 police personnel injured in the incident. The police are claiming the locals attacked them with stones and they had to use force. Meanwhile, the Assam government has ordered a probe into the firing incident. Here's more.
Police brutality on camera. These visuals are from Darang district in Assam. A man who was charging at the police with a stick is beaten black and blue. The police also open fire. At least 2 people died, including the man on the screen. Even as he lay motionless, the police rain blows on him. A photographer accompanying the police kept kicking him, jumping on his chest until he is restrained. All this is the result of an anti-encroachment drive that went wrong. The police say locals attacked them with stones and they had to use force. Darang SP Sushant Biswa Sarma confirmed the death of 2 civilians. 9 policemen are injured. He, however, did not react to the video of violence that has gone viral. The state government has launched a drive to remove 800 families from 4,500 bighas of land meant for a farming project. Today's eviction drive was part of it. The Assam Minority Students Union staged a protest against the drive.
সরকারে জি অমানবীয় কাম করেছে অন্যায় করেছে এই অন্যায় আমি অসমীয় যুব পরিষদে তীব্র বাহারে নিন্দা করছো কারণ আমি দেখা পাইছো এই বিগত বিজেপি সরকারখনে একটা ষড়যন্ত্র চলাই আছে মিয়া জনজাতিক টার্গেট করে ষড়যন্ত্র চলাই আছে.
The opposition Congress has condemned the violence.
ये आदमी को क्यों गोली मार के मारा गया? ये जो गोली मारने का निर्देश दिया, ये चीफ मिनिस्टर का खुद का भाई है, ये सीएम का भाई ने कानून को कैसे हाथ में ले सकता है?
The Assam government claims the land recovered will be used to start a farming project as was originally planned. But the violence on Friday has cast a shadow on the whole exercise. Bureau Report, India Today.
And joining me now is Kaushik Deka, Deputy Editor at India Today, to tell us more about this incident. Kaushik, there are 2 ways to look at it. One is alleged illegal encroachers violently attacking police forces. But surely there is a way to retaliate and deal with them. What we've seen is clear police brutality and even a photojournalist involved in it. What's your sense? What are you picking up? What is it that explains this kind of police behavior?
First of all, whatever the provocation is and whatever the justification for illegal eviction is, what happened on Monday, that September 28th, it cannot be justified. This is inhuman and unacceptable. And entire Assam, whether someone supports illegal immigration or not, whether someone supports the NRC movement, someone supports the CA, it doesn't matter. Everyone in Assam is united in this, that whatever happened, that visual, it's inhuman and it's unacceptable. Having said that, this issue of illegal immigration and this eviction and encroachment of government land and land belonging to religious institutes or forest land, means there are 15 districts in Assam where lands have been encroached. There are around 22 square hectares of forest land, which is 22% of forest land of India, of Assam, which has been encroached by illegal immigrants. These are facts. But that doesn't mean that the way to evict people is this.
No, but is it because Hemanta Biswa Sarma is seeing himself as this muscular chief minister? There are now reports that the number of instances involving police violence since the chief minister took over 4 months ago have increased. It almost seems as if he's given the police this license to, dare I say, kill.
About eviction, the drive that happened also in the earlier regime, that is Sarbananda Sonowal's time, around Kaziranga and in Nogao, there are many places where we saw this eviction drive. But when it comes to police force, the use of muscular force, the police force, yes, we are seeing encounters every day. Every criminal who has been arrested today in Assam, he, invariably the very next day we would hear a news that he tried to escape from police custody and he has been shot. Or some are killed in encounters. So that has, the chief minister has very openly said that the police can use force and the criminal should be tackled in the harshest possible way.
Clearly that can lead to police then believing that they can get away with a license to kill. Just one final quick answer. The role of that photojournalist. I'm told he's a local district government photographer. How is it being explained that the official photographer has joined the police in beating up someone who's already almost half dead?
That explanation has to be done by the district administration. First of all, he should not be there at such a spot. Means he can be doing his photography and everything, but taking action, and he has done that not once, repeatedly he has done that, and he should have been taken away. And even now, he hasn't been arrested.
I'm told he's just been arrested. I'm told, Kaushik, in fact, we are getting news that he's just been arrested for what he's done.
Yeah, so
it is completely unacceptable.
Since Monday, this is Thursday evening. Mm-hmm. And after all this uproar, he has been arrested now. He should have been arrested immediately at the spot. Because if we have seen it in the video today, they saw it. That day itself.
Very, very solid points. Remember also, of course, the chief minister himself, I think his brother is in the police force in the district. So clearly that puts even greater pressure. So in that sense now, this has become a major political issue. Kaushik Deka, as always...
In fact, this overdrive is actually damaging the whole eviction exercise, which is very important for Assam.
Right.
Because illegal immigration and encroachment is a serious issue.
Neither does it give anyone the justification for resorting to the kind of violence that we've seen.
Exactly.
Kaushik Deka joining me there from Guwahati.